Okay, perfect. So welcome all to again the third day of the session. And today we're going to speak about Dinacharya, which is actually a daily routine. And it is indicated for maintenance of health as such for a healthy person and to get rid of the complications of a disease if you are a diseased person. So these are two options that we have when we follow the Dinacharya. And actually speaking, it's a long turn. It can be, you can consider yourself a self-doctor when you who can analyze your health, who can analyze your body when you are doing your Dinacharya, if you are doing it regularly. So starting with Pratharuthana, waking up. You can see that I put here a nice baby's face. How many of you can assure yourself or tell me that you are getting up like this? Hello?
Myself, Aparna? Myself. I get up around, yes, Aparna. Yeah.
So,
I get up around 3:34.
Oh, daily?
3:34.
Okay. Without an alarm clock?
Yes. I don't know. It's just automatically just wake up. Yeah.
Really happy to meet you. Such people are rare. Actually speaking, many of the people find it really difficult to get up at Brahma Muhurta. I put it here from 3 a.m. to 6 a.m. It is actually the last yama of sleep. But what happens is, we extend the sleep again from 6 o'clock to even 9 o'clock. Some people even until 11 o'clock. So, it is always wonderful to get up at this Brahma Muhurta. There are so many reasons behind it. Actually speaking, when I asked you, are you waking up with an alarm clock? Yes, actually the speak, I intended to ask this question because nowadays we are waking up with an alarm clock, again snoozing it for 15 to 20 minutes and then again snoozing it, trying to snooze at least for 3-4 times and then only getting up. The problem is that it actually assures us that our body is in need of some sleep or some rest. That means that it is taking a toll on your health. The whole routine of your life is taking a toll on your health and you really have to make sure that you do something, some justice to your body, which is actually the wall that is actually taking yourself to the whole ambience that you are in, to your work, to your family, all that. So this physical body also demands some care and that care is actually called this Dinacharya. And this Dinacharya, wherein it begins with Pratharuthana, waking up, the one thing that they have mentioned is that while getting up, you have to get up without taking all your memories of the past. You have to get up fresh. Without the memories of the past means, it also means a physical past. Whatever you have taken the previous day should also be digested completely. You're not taking it to the next day. That means it becomes an indigestion kind of material that you're taking up. So you have to eat also very early so that you have such an early morning. And then if you have to get up early morning by 3 o'clock, can you at least imagine by 10 o'clock at least you have to be at bed. Otherwise, you will not get that adequate amount of sleep, which is approximately 5 to 6 hours for an adult. And it can vary based on the age groups also. And as per the need of the body, you know, it is like some people are very much satisfied if they have even 3 hours of deep sleep. But without that, some people will not find it enough even if you sleep for 6 hours. So, at least that minimum gap you have to fill yourself in your day. And make sure the food you take is easily digestible so that what happens is the sleep will not be disturbed, not very spicy. What happens is when you take very spicy food, it actually acts with your acid levels and can cause irritation in your stomach. And most of the people with GERD problems, that is gastroesophageal reflux disease, they have problems only because they take very spicy diet, especially during that night. So what happens is there is that acid movement, you know. Therein it is actually getting that esophagus whole part itself a little bit corroded, I should say. Because all of us have that mucus material around the esophagus, which is actually destroyed when you are taking very spicy food at late night of hours. And without digestion, you're going to sleep. So obviously that digestion process is creating a problem. And the GRD, such problems are all just because of this. Insomnia is one of the problems that you have to attend to. Many of the people think that as you age grow by, you will not have enough sleep. Let me tell you, your vata is on the rise. That is why you're not able to sleep, because that is a normal pattern. As you age go by, the vata will increase in the body. But that doesn't mean that you should not have adequate sleep, because adequate sleep is that which is that you are trying to moderate your vata. So kind of light oil application on the head, application of oil at the feet. It's called Pada Abhyanga. It is a wonderful medicine for insomnia. Just take two or three drops of oil. It is preferably sesame oil, because that is the best oil to control your vata. And then apply. If it is very cold season, you can apply just two or three drops of olive oil. Don't use mustard oil, because it will be very, very, very hot. That hotness is not required, especially because you have your oil reflex in your pada, the sole of the feet, you know. So it has to be very tender. You can use best is to apply sesame oil or olive oil. Next comes Malodsarga. It is the elimination of bowels that we have to do immediately after waking up. That means that when you get up by 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock, you actually have the urge immediately. But as your time goes by, the digestive pattern takes a toll and you will not feel that natural urge by itself. So what happens? You have to take a tea. Some people take hot water. Some you have to take a real good walk and come, and then only you will have your bowel habit. So all of these can be changed if just by getting up early itself. But if at all you get up late, so what can be done? Is drink warm water with a little bit of ghee. That is actually best, so that you are trying to control your breather. You're trying to remove the problem. At the same time, you're not doing any harm to the body also. Okay? And make sure that you attend to the vega. It is actually called vega. Any reflex, like you're feeling you want to sneeze, you want to drink water, all these are actually reflexes of the body. That is the demand of the body. And especially the flatus, feces, and then of urine, you should never control, because it is connected with the sacral nerves, and you will have problems in due course of time with very, very, the problems which cannot be reversed. So make sure you are attending to the vagas as and then when it is required. So if at all you have a problem of constipation, I would say try using this dry grapes with a little bit of soap and a little bit of water, or dry grapes which is actually put in castor oil. One or two if you take regularly also, it is not going to be a problem. But even after doing that, if you have a problem, that means that your digestive pattern itself is a problem. So you have to meet a doctor, okay? Next comes brushing of teeth. All of you would have seen this neem twig, but have you ever tried this? Anyone who's tried this neem twig?
I think almost everybody must have, you know, tried. People from my generation, even though I'm not very old, but yes, we have all tried.
From north would have used babul instead of neem twig, because babul is very commonly available there. And in south India we use neem because of the prevalence that we have. And
I have used these neem and babul. I'm 70 years old, and I'm still quite active, and you may say quite young also. So I have used all these. When I used to go to my village, and then I go. Yes, thank you.
Actually speaking, this Danta Davana was actually an initiation for how you're going to eat. That is how the Danta Davana is itself mentioned. Danta and Davana. It is Danta means teeth and Davana is cleaning. So you are advised to clean it anyway, but the cleaning is best to be done with a neem twig or a babul twig. Because just because of the presence of the taste, you can see the taste is bitter and also it has got that pungent and astringent taste. So have you ever tasted anything bitter and then taken water?
Yes, I have taken.
No,
I have
not
taken neem leaves, and after that I have taken water.
Okay, how do you feel?
Sweet,
exactly. Actually, even the best example would be an Indian gooseberry. If you take an Indian gooseberry also, you have all these tastes except for the salty taste. It is one material that has got five tastes. And because of the combination itself, you can actually, when you take it and after that, when you take water, it will be just like Amrit. Because it clarifies, the bitter is one flavor that actually can clean the tongue and also enable the buds to analyze the betterment of the taste. Whatever you're going to eat next will actually be enhanced. The taste of the material will be enhanced. So what happens is, immediately after your Danta Davana itself, you will start feeling hungry. That is how the Danta Davana is being planned. After that, the material, it can be of any herb. It is not required that it should be babul neem. There are so many materials like Tejovati, Irimeda. All these are actually drugs which are helping it.
Sorry.
Aparna, someone is
Everybody, you all put your mics in mute. You will be able to hear properly. If you want to speak, please on the mic and switch off the mic later on so that we can hear properly. There's a lot of disturbance.
I think now it's clear. Okay. Yeah. Now, the second point I showed you is like it has the specific length and size and all, because it is actually indicated that it should be chewed, and then for brushing also the same material is used. So it can be like, it is only indicated that you need to have of a specific length. So our brush and all, you can see it is not going up certain beyond a certain length. That is actually as per this 12 angula only. Angula means this is the size actually. It's actually of the index finger. You have the breadth of the index finger, that is actually called one angula, and 12 times of it. So approximately like four fingers, if you keep three times, it's almost like 12 angula, and that's the length of the twig that you have to use it. And apart from when you're brushing with this material, you can also damage a little bit of your gums and all that. So in case you have any problems like stomatitis or something, you are advised against using the twigs. So instead, you have to use the powder of the same quantity of drugs, same material of drugs. And the same can actually be used for enhancing the gums also. The good thing is that you will not get affected by any of the bacterial issues, any of the fungal issues, because this neem, babul, irimeda, all of these drugs have been studied for creating such an antimicrobial action. And you do not get anything with even of the best mouthwashes. And let me tell you now, when you go back and look into the mouthwash, toothpaste and all, somewhere it will be written Ayurvedic. That is the sad part. So it is best to use, assess the drugs. See, this is actually one of the picture which shows wherein we had some of the students, we asked them to try. It's called the Danta Davana Churna. You have the called Danta Davana Churna. Any of these powder, just of the neem itself you can use, but it's very bitter in taste. So arimeda, such material can be used so that it is creating that you know, just by rubbing itself you can have the gums all that strengthen, and at the same time you can remove the dirt also by the using of these drugs. Next comes anjanam. You would have you would see me putting collyrium. I prefer rather than using the eyebrow, like the eyeliner and all that, I use always anjana, which is actually very good for the body. Speaking, the eyes are always considered as a site of pitta, and your pitta should be very sharp, because you have that agni in you, then only you're able to visualize the light, the visualizing of light, and then enabling to differentiate between the colored and the black and white and all that. So these are the properties of the pitta which actually helps us. But at the same time, this whole bhaga is actually a dominant place of kapha. So always there is a tendency that you can see that you will always have dirt accumulation. That is because you have this kapha, and then it is creating that kind of dirty sensation. So daily when you actually wash, that's why it's a tendency that after getting up in the morning, you wash and make sure that your eye dirt and everything has been removed. But this itself, if it is not removed in a proper way, can create problems. So this Savviranjanam is the daily used collyrium that we say. It can be used in a regular manner. Generally, there is a content called antimony bisulfide, which is actually used. It's a mineral that can be used for medicine effect and cosmetic effect. So, if you purchase from outside and all, this is the material that is there in the anjana, actually, which is properly traditionally prepared. And the next one you can see is rasanjana, which is actually used once a week. Generally, rasanjana is a material which is prepared from this Berberis haristata. We call it Daru Haridra. And it is a material which is prepared with the milk and all that, but still it is so irritant. It is like an irritant that is used for the eyes, and it helps clear out. It is like draining the kapha. You can see the picture. We use it like application, just like how we put the collyrium itself, we apply, and it can also be used as drops. This is the medicine which actually we use, Elanir Kolambu. It is, there are so many materials also, like Karpuradi Kolambu and all that there, but this is a very commonest medicine because it is not very sharp, and once you use it, after all this draining, you see the second picture, the watery element, everything will come out. You once you apply, you have to actually blink your eyes, open your and close your eyelids often. So what happens is, once you drain completely, you will feel an effect that is actually like it is real bliss. I should say it gives you the cooling effect. So mostly in summers and all, people regularly use it. Regularly use it means you should use only once a week, because if you use it too much also, what happens is there is a drying effect also, because it actually creates an irritancy, and then it is creating that watering content, manner, and then only it removes the dirt. So when you're using it daily, it will actually create a problem. But once a week is such a healthy manner of keeping your eyes protected. And this is actually the traditional method. You can see the hand is actually having a wick. Now, the wick is actually to be prepared in a specific manner. You can either dip it in lemon juice, and at the same time, you have to have this bringaraja. You would have heard about this bringa, which is very healthy for the hair and all that. But the same leaf, it is very effective, because it is a wonderful medicine for pitta problems. So that is why we advise using Eclipta alba. It's a very small plant, a beautiful plant, I should say. It has a very small white flower, and the leaves are also very soft in nature, and you get some juice when you extract it. And so the leaves are collected, it is the juice taken, and the wick is actually soaked in it and then dried. And it is dried for 7 days. If you mean like today it will be soaked and kept for for half an hour or so, it is soaked in that liquid, and then it is actually kept for drying. The next day again fresh liquid is taken, it is again kept for drying. Like that 7 days will be done, and the last day we will put it in lemon juice. It is lemon juice is actually that it is like a counter irritant, and at the same time it is actually going to keep that cooling effect also. So for both of these conditions only we're doing that. And once this wick is ready, it is actually soaked, just two or three drops of castor oil is put and it is burnt. And you can either use such a stainless steel vessel, or the best would be to use a traditional kind of setup in which you have a sharava. We call it sharava. It's like a covering of a pot. You would have seen just like a bowl, just like a plate actually. It is made up of mud. In that, what we do is first apply a coating of ghee or castor oil, and then it is made to fire like this, and the soot is actually collected. Once the soot is collected, you can keep this vessel intact, because anytime you can use this for daily application. This is actually the preparation of, as I told you, the Sauviranjana, daily used collyrium, which can be used daily after preparing at home. So you can make sure that you are not doing any harm to your eyes. I cannot assure you, if you are using from outside daily used Anjana, how good it is. But this is actually pure. It will not create any harm. You will not have any burning sensation also when you're doing so. This is the nasya. You can see drops of oil which is being instilled in each of the nasal nostril is actually called as nasya. Now, this nose is actually considered more like a gateway for the head. It is actually called as nasahi shiraso dwara. So, we consider this as a two holes wherein we can enter up to the brain. So what we do is, whatever medicine, there are so many types of medicine that can be used for the nasya material, but simplest would be to use anuthailam, we call it anuthailam. You can use two drops daily of, or even better would be to use sesame oil daily, two drops into each nostril. You have to actually have your head in a bent position. It is called head low position. And then you apply these two drops and try to inhale deep, so that after some time you feel some kind of mucus or the phlegm which is getting accumulated in your throat, and that has to be spat out. After that, just gargle with hot water, which is actually boiled with ginger would be even better. Otherwise, just gargling with hot water itself is fine. Now, this is a medicine which is actually very effective in cases of regular sinusitis, headaches, migraine, all such headache problems, all inflammatory conditions of your face, and then to your brain in cases of even demyelinating conditions, it is very effective. So, it's like a very, you can actually use medicines in so much quantities also. We use it like panchakarma. It's actually one of the panchakarmas, but as a daily routine, it is advised only two drops. We go up to even 30 drops for some patients. Okay. And the material also differs. The sesame oil and anuthailam is a basic one, which can be used at home. And daily, immediately after brushing, this is what you can do. And that is like a regular course. In due course of time, you can see difference in your face. The wrinkles actually will disappear. And then you will see a difference also in your graying of hair, hair loss and all that. This is actually dhumapana. So you can see the twig and how the fumes come out of it. This twig is actually, it's called a cigar. And the cigar is actually made up of just... At home, if you have preparing, you can just add a little bit of turmeric powder along with ghee, roll it out. Roll it out in a way that you are making a cigar-like material, and that is actually smoked. But the smoking cannot be direct. It has to be only in the form of this cone-like structure. Actually, we have different types of material for smoking, but the simplest would be to use this, because once you have this nasya done, no, you will have some kind of irritation if the oil remains. Only when you are using that oil in excess, actually speaking, two drops will not create much of a problem. But still, it will be best to use this also, because it will kind of remove whatever is remaining stagnant in the nostrils. And this is called Abhyanga, which is like daily application of oil, and it has to be applied especially on the head where you have to apply is the Brahma. It is just 2-3 drops, not more. And then on the ears and feet, because feet means it is not only feet, it is also the soles of hand, palms, and also the soles of feet. Now, these are points which are actually having this terminal neuralgic effect. And so these points have to be surely oiled, because we consider these as places of Vata, and the coordination of our, like for ears, if we have to have coordination of hearing, it is very important that some oiling has to happen, because if at all you have more of Vata accumulation in your ears, you kind of start getting this sound. It's called tinnitus. Most of the people who start your getting older, no, they start getting this, because the Vata will actually be increased in their body. And so just applying one drop of oil, it is only one drop. Actually, the advice is that you have to dip your smallest finger in oil, and just the smallest drop that will be there, you have to apply. And then just squeeze it through. That's it. Apart from that, you don't have to pour in oil. It is just one drop. Pouring of oil is another treatment. We don't want you to do at home. And at the same time,
which oil applying, is this?
Yes, pardon?
Which oil? Is this sesame oil or?
Sesame oil is the best. Sesame oil is the best. And if it is getting colder, you can use even olive oil. Not to go for mustard oil, because it's very hot. You should not be using mustard oil and all on the head, because it will affect the eyes.
How about coconut oil? Okay.
Coconut oil is also best. If you have a very pitta type of body, coconut oil is the best. Like if your body skin is of a normal temperament, no, not very dry and all, then you can use coconut oil, because coconut oil has actually got lyric acid, which is very good for the skin. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And apart from that, first you apply on the head, ears and feet, and then just a film of oil to be applied on the whole body. Stay for 45 minutes if it is possible. Otherwise, just 15 to 20 minutes itself will give you such wonders. So if you can do that, please do that. And it helps. See, the first one is warding off old age. Everyone wants that. It's like anti-aging, because the oil that actually goes to the body is tending to each cell, outer cell, which is getting exposed to the daily atmosphere, so that atmospheric variation will be easily nourished up. No, so whatever we are deteriorating externally will be daily. If you are doing this daily, it is like you are in energizing your body daily. And then excretion means, yesterday I told you about the Sveda. When you apply this oil, you can see in some minutes itself, there will be some sweat drops, because that is like you are enabling that perspiration to happen because of that heat developed because of that application of oil. And aggravation of Vata, obviously that will be controlled. You will have nice skin, healthy skin, and improves your vision. Vision, as I told you, when you're applying in the head, it is actually helping to improve all your sense organs. It helps improve your vision. It helps improve your hearing. It helps even in your nasal and taste buds improvement. Nourishes the whole body, enhances sleep. This oil application is one method in which your sleep can also be enhanced. And the third line you can see is that aggravated kapha. Aggravated kapha means in case of a common cold. If one catches up a common cold. What happened? Excuse me. Can I continue?
No. Yes, you can continue, Aramya.
Okay. So, in case of aggravated kapha, which means here that some kind of common cold sensation, or if you're having a cough or something like a breathing discomfort, or like you have this rhinitis, in such conditions and all, it is better to avoid this oil application, because the application of this oil can actually increase the problem. So it is better to avoid during that period, maybe for a week, and then get back to your normal routine. And indigestion, excuse me. Indigestion is one important thing, because whenever you apply oil, it is actually your digestion that is also getting improved. So if you're having a sloggy stomach or if you're feeling full, you should not apply. You should not apply oil once you have taken food also. So there, it is actually advised all of these before your food intake. So it is to increase your appetite and all that. So always this has to be in mind that it should be done only on empty stomach. Next is vyayama. Actually, everyone goes for exercises, and after some period of time, you get this problems of pain at the joints and all that. But try applying oil and then doing this. I'm sure that you will not have any of these problems. And exercises is always advised to be of half hour limit. That means that you should not be straining your body. But at the same time, if you have enough quantity of fat, you can do it. And there are specific seasons wherein you are advised to do also, especially the cool season, and wherein you have to perspire, because generally in cold season, we don't perspire. So to perspirate and to remove whatever is not required in our body, that is one way that has been advised. And it has to be avoided by people who have already this vata and pitta aggravation, like a kind of acidity problems and all. They have to actually be very careful. And then in case of joint problems like rheumatoid arthritis and all that, they should take the advice of the person who is treating and then go for exercises. This is mardana. That is a slight difference only about the abhyanga and mardana. Abhyanga is actually the oil application, and mardana is the real oil massage. So you can see there is actually a sequence. Once you have to apply the oil and then undergo the exercise, and then you're getting all your body just squeezed up, or a kind of different types of massage techniques can be used. Actually, this has been advised because once you undergo this exercise and all, your body will get strained. So to remove that strain only, we are doing this oil massage as such. But the oil application can be done regularly. So it would always be best. Actually, I would always advise that if you can do some exercise with the help, with after application of oil, you are actually going to create an ease also, because the oils that we have, as per Ayurveda, we have so many of oil combinations also, which are actually indicated for relaxing your muscles and bone. So it will help you also in long run. And this is Urdhvartana. Just this is not to be done by everyone daily, because this is like a powder massage, which you will require people to do it. But this is also advised as a part, because whatever kapha that gets accumulated us in the morning, that is to be removed. And in case of obesity, such conditions and all, this powder, dry powder massage will help in liquefying the fat. So whatever material that we use in this is actually very dry and rough in tendency. So it actually helps in liquefying the fat and remove it as perspiration. And the best part of it is that you will get a nice rubbed massage by the skin. So what happens is all that blemishes, all that will go off. After that, you have a nice skin, glowing skin. Then this comes as a last. This comes as a last, because after doing all this, you have to remove every dirt pieces and every dirt from your mind and body. You are advised to have a bath. Now, I intently put this as a girl bathing under the waterfall, because the one of my sir used to say, actually, when we are having a bath, most of us now tend to have this warm water bath, because we are very lazy getting bathed in cold water. Actually speaking, until this, you should be putting only cold water, and below the clavicle, it is that you should put warm water. It is only warm water, not hot water. Warm water is advised below the clavicle, and cold water above the clavicle, because all of these parts are very tender, and we need to actually keep the strength of it, because all of these are very tender. and it has been nourished also in a very subtle way. So to keep up with the strength of the eyes, the eyesight, hearing aid, all this, you are advised to actually use cold water on the head, which imparts nourishment to the upper part of the body. And then these are parts actually which are affected by Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So here it is not a problem that you are using warm water. And once you, I don't know how many of you have tried, you've been a very cold winter also. If you put one mug of water on your head, how do you feel?
Aparna,
no answers? Yes.
Very
yes,
refreshed.
The first thing that you feel.
Very refreshed.
It is actually, you have a jerk, right?
Yeah, that jerk in the morning when you take the cold water, and especially when you put it on your head, you just freeze for a couple of seconds.
Yes.
Or
that
maybe a minute.
It is to awaken your vata, or it is awakening yourself to get ready for the whole day. It is awakening of your whole inner self. So that is why it has actually got so much of thing to do with your, like, your vata should not be very sloggy, because once it is sloggy, you will not be able to grasp things, you will not be able to do things and all that. So it has to be very much quickened up. And that is actually an initiation of making your vata getting up in the morning. So because the morning, you can see everywhere, it is the kapha that will be dominant. And so to put that out daily as a regular routine only, we are doing all these things. And finally, we are doing with a snana, so that the vata will be actually activated. And at the same time, whatever is not needed by the body, like sweat, dirt, exhaustion, thirst, and all that can be removed. Now, this is... Excuse me. Aparna, I think someone
kindly
please, if there's no questions, excuse me for request, please find the new answer at the end. Thank
okay.
you.
So we've come to the last point. Actually, I wanted to show this because I'll stop presenting so that we'll be able to see. I can hear my voice.
Yeah, we are all hearing
you. You are audible, ma'am. Please carry on. You are audible.
Okay. Fine.
Can
you close the door, please? Okay. So that's for today. I just wanted to make sure that this dinachari is put through, because this is actually considered as a regimen wherein we can make sure that we're not affected by the daily routine of Vata, Pitta and Kapha. It is like we're trying to clear off whatever is not necessary in the beginning itself. So it's always good that if you can induce all these measures to your children, especially people who are below 10 years, that would be the best. Because it will become like a habit. And that habit is what is required, because many degenerative problems, many connective tissue disorders are all coming up these later years. You know, like even I have seen children of just in the age of 12, 13 who are having problems related to these, you know. In olden times, at least 5 years back, people did not have these connective tissue disorders or degenerative conditions in these age groups. It was only after 50, 60 and all they had, and demyelinating diseases and all that. So many of the diseases are coming up only because we are not tending to it. So I wanted to make sure that this is put through. So that's why I put this. I wanted this topic also to be part of the our talk. Okay. Yeah, now please, I think we can have some questions.
Well, thank you very much, madam. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. We have got many important tips from you for our health.
Thank you.
And we are grateful to you. Regarding the bathing, you said as the warm water should be below the clavicle bone.
Yes.
And above at the head, it should be the cold water where most of the sensory organs of our body are located. So, will that cold water will not flow to down below?
Below the clavicle also? You know, it is actually better that head bend position, that would be better. Or you can actually have your first head bath and then shift on to hot water bath. Generally, when you are having this doubt, it is advised that you have this head separately with cold water.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Is it a good idea to wash your hairs every single day? Is it a good idea to wash your hairs every single day with just the normal water?
No. Actually, with normal water, it's fine, but not with shampoo. I am dead against shampoo.
So what can be used instead of shampoo? What can be used?
Yes, instead of shampoo, the best thing would be to use hibiscus leaf. You can actually dry it. Hibiscus is a very common plant everywhere. And you can actually get the dried powder of it. If it is not so, even use Rita along with Amlaki. You know, Rita is actually the soap nut powder. You can get it easily, Rita. And then Amlaki means it is a gooseberry, Indian gooseberry. You can dry it and use it. These both powder itself, actually speaking, this soap nut, when you put it in water, it gives you enough lather. And if you are using it with a combination of Amlaki powder, you are actually doing justice to your hair only. It will help growth. At the same time, it will help eliminate whatever is not necessary for your body. I don't think you. We are all working with dust that you need to wash your hair daily. You can just wash with plain water. And apart from that, make sure you're applying daily just 2 drops of oil on the head. Because that quantity actually makes sure you're taking care of your sense organs. It is not only for you, your hair, that you have to apply oil. For oil application, hair improvement and all, you can apply oil which is actually as per your hair temperament. And at the same time, there you will require some guidance. So it is better that you follow some physician's idea, wherein you're having hair fall, dandruff and all such conditions has to be taken care. But apart from that, it is better just to use wash with normal water. And then once a week, you can apply this, use this powder. Even twice a week also, if you use this powder, it is not going to harm.
Yeah. We have a question from Rajesh Kolji.
Yeah,
please unmute yourself, sir.
I have unmuted. Hello. Am I audible?
Yeah. Very much.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm Rajesh calling from Germany. First of all, thanks for the nice presentation and thanks for the invitation.
You're welcome.
And I have somewhere learned that, you know, each organ system of our body has a particular healing time, you know, kind of a repairing time, you know, and most of the heart attacks happen in the early morning period.
Midnight. Early morning, yeah.
That's when it beats at its fastest, you know, and those who are weak at it. And so when the person, and at the same time, we are advised to get up early in the morning and we take a bath. And bath is also advised, somewhere I've learned, that we take water in the foot first, not in the head first. Is that so? Am I right? Or should we make our foot wet first with water, then go upwards? Like when we enter
it is still contradictory
because I've read it that like in ancient times people used to enter a river, you know, they used to dip their feet first,
put the feet river, first,
and that is how it went up, and this took care of the blood circulation system, you know, kind of, and that prevented many sort of, you know, blood circulation problems from occurring, you know, which can be sudden when a person takes a sudden bath, you know.
I actually accept that because generally, as you said, when you're going to a river or a flowing water, you have actually not very cold water or not very hot water there. You can see that the temperament will be perfect for the body. That is how you have to actually bath. But the problem is we either get it hot or we either get it cold. And the way he said is actually fine because it is actually advisable that you are trying to make yourself a little bit warm and then you're going to that colder side. That is fine. And one more thing I wanted to put through is there is a way that you mix it with hot and cold water. Please do not try to do that because, you know, you would have seen how iron is being heated and then when it is dipped, again you heat it and then you again dip it in cold liquid. After some period of time, no, you can actually bend that iron piece. Yes. So even when iron can be bent, we are all very supple people. We can also be bent and affected by diseases.
During the bath,
yes, it should be either, you know, when I mean that hot water, you should not mix it with cold water again. So it's always better that it is tepid, like when you're heating itself, it should be just warm.
That is part of some therapy, hot and cold shock yes. therapy. That is provided perhaps given in the sole of the foot when a person has some sort of a problem, acne problem in the heel.
No, actually, yes. That is for a person who has a problem. But when you're talking about healthy people, it is actually advised either that use cold water itself or you either use it or warm itself. You should not mix it.
Yeah, fair enough. And I want to congratulate somewhere. I learned that even the MBBS stream of medicine would be taught Ayurveda now in the syllabus.
Yes. Thank you.
It's good that we are going the holistic way. All the best. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you. And now integrative medicine is actually on its way.
Yeah. That should be the way.
Yeah. Thank you.
So, Arunya, we have a question from Upesh Dutai ji.
I just want to
please unmute and ask your question.
I wanted to ask this Vita powder, how do we use it on the hair?
Which one?
The Rita powder.
Okay.
Yeah. How do we use it?
It is actually that try to get fine powder prepared and then you actually have to mix it with water. Do not use plain Rita because it is very drying also. So that is why I asked to be mixed it with Amlaki powder, which is very, very, very much available also. This gooseberry powder, no, you can easily avail it also. So you have to actually use 1:1 and then mix it with a little bit of water, soak it and then use. Otherwise, there is another way that you can do is you try to make a coarse powder of both of these material, keep it separately. The previous day you can do is take one whole glass of water, boil these two materials and just keep it after settling that water for some time. Then the next day when you take it, it will be, you can just take that liquid part and that will be more like a shampoo for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right. Welcome. Aruna, I'm going to ask a few questions as well, because today's entire thing is on
there are two voices coming up, Aparna. I'm sorry. I'm not audible.
Unmute yourself.
Aramya?
Yeah.
You need to mute Chandrasekhar.
Yeah, please.
You need to mute Chandrasekhar.
Okay.
Chandrasekhar ji, please mute yourself. I think Chandrasekhar ji has some question. Please go ahead, sir. Please go ahead.
Actually, I'm his wife, Mala. Hi, okay. Aramya.
Hello.
Fantastic hearing you, though I missed the first day of Agni and I would like to catch up on that. Okay. For today, I wanted to know which powder do you use for the powder massage?
It is like a combination of powders. To actually say that you would be aware of this horse gram. It is
what is that? Sorry,
horse gram.
Horse gram.
It's called Kulatta. I'm not sure of the Hindi name. And then we have a combination of
which it is called Kulit in Hindi.
Pardon? Sorry?
Kulit in Hindi.
Yes. Kulit, right. Yes. Okay, and then we have a combination of material which are medicated actually.
Bola scope in the appeal kuchi, bola.
You mean
horse gram, is it? Horse gram powder.
Horse gram powder along with the medicated powders, like we use this Shatapushpa, we use fenugreek, and we have other materials also, like Rasna, Devadaru, and all these materials which are actually hot in the idea is that you have to create the heat. And at the same time, it has to be dry and rough, because the intensity of material will keep that tendency to sweat out, and that sweating will help dissolve the fat.
So can we say that we can mix fenugreek powder with horse gram powder and use that for the massage?
That will not help actually, because we need the medicated powders also. It will help you for certain limits, but not give you the real benefits.
So where to get the medicated powder from?
You can get it from like Kottam Chukkadi Churnam. This is one material. I can Kottam Chukkadi.
You can see it down in medical shops, right?
Yeah, you can get
Kottakal or any Ayurvedic medical shop.
Yeah.
Okay, so what's the name again, please? Can it be typed?
You can see that is Kottam Chukkadi Churnam.
Oh, I got it. Thank you so much.
Aranya, type it. Yes, the rest please. Of the people.
Hello. Doctor?
Yeah, please.
Good evening.
Umaji here.
Yeah. Actually, okay. My name is Anita.
Okay.
I have a question. My mother is 82 years old.
Okay.
So right now, just now, her shivering has started in her hands.
Okay.
Very much. Recently, I lost my brother. So that is a big shock for mother also.
Okay.
So after that incident, the shivering has increased. So any home remedies to control that?
You can actually start applying oil on the hair. There is a oil called Shirabala that you can get.
Okay.
And you can apply it both on the head and at the same time on the whole part of the body. Like especially the part which is shivering more. It will actually start helping. But then if you require some medication help also, I think you will, this I'm telling it to be used for 1 week, and then you can get back to me with connections on how you feel she's faring. Based on that, we'll work it out.
Okay. Kshirabala.
Kshirabala Thailand. Yeah.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. Yeah. And
it's a traditional medicine. It's a classical medicine. You can get it from any Ayurvedic shop.
Yeah.
That I know. Kshirabala Thailam, I know. How to contact you, madam?
I think Aparnaji will be sharing my number.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Where do you practice, Aramyaji?
Coimbatore at Ayurvedic Pharmacy. And then I have my own clinic, Ojas Ayurveda Clinic. And then I am consultant with Saukya Ayurveda, which is actually run for mainly multiple sclerosis condition patients and people with disabilities. So I'm a consultant there also. Here with Aparna ji, we are working out on the psychology also.
So what's your suggestion for acute knee pain, ma'am?
Acute knee pain, you have to really meet a doctor because we have to understand what the condition is. But if you are actually gradually trying to have your knee pain started, then it is best that you start applying warm sesame oil. Warm, it should be really warm. And then stay for some time and then use warm water to wash it off. Once you get removed of the pain, then it will be fine. If it is not, you have to meet a doctor because acute knee pain can suggest many things. Hope I'm clear, Ramadevi.
Yeah. Thank you so much. No, because ma'am, lots of people who have the knee pain.
Yes. Actually, when you, that's why this Abhyanga itself was intended that you are not to get any of these arthritis problems at all. I should say that my grandmother, until the age of, she passed away at the age of 93. But until then, she was walking 2 days before also, until the death. She was not in deathbed. She was just walking and only for 2 days she was on bed, I should say. And I have always seen her with oil. Like every evening, she would sit for that half an hour with that oil. And that is actually a learning process for me, I should say, that no, she has never complained of pain in the hand or pain in the leg, anywhere. So it is a very simple thing that we can do at home. Make yourself available for that half an hour for yourself. At least 20 minutes.
Yeah, so that's the sesame oil she applied, is it, every day?
Actually, in Kerala, it's a practice that we use Dhanvantram Thailam.
Oh.
Dhanvantram Thailam, but yeah, that is why I said sesame oil is the best. If you can check out for the any oil, it is not a problem at all. Sesame oil is the best.
It's just the lubrication that's important.
Yes, the lubrication, the material. Sesame oil has the property of taking care of your joints. That is why it is very good for your bones and muscles.
Yes. And what can be done?
I'm back again. You know, some from sesame oil, they add a tinge of fresh lemon juice and then they apply. It's extremely effective.
Actually, I would say if you're using it fresh, it is okay. But if in case of swelling and all, you can use that combination. If it is plain and you don't have any swelling, it is always best to apply the oil as such.
Can we apply the oil and just go to sleep?
No.
Can we leave it overnight?
A big no. It will actually create problems rather than giving you help. Because it is just like how you over apply or create problems. Actually, it's like there is a paka avastha. The body itself undergoes a proper type of cooking. It has to be properly digested by the body. And when it is not happening, it becomes like an indigestion for the body. And the same thing will happen when you apply it at night and leave it on. So that is why I said after 20 minutes or 30 minutes, you have to make sure that it has been removed by the usage of hot water.
Mic is on.
Okay.
Is it the same for hair oil also?
Yes.
Is it the same for hair oil also?
Surely. Many of the people have problems of sinusitis, long-standing headache and all because of this reason.
So because normally they used to say, put your oil your hair at night, go off to sleep. That's not good.
No.
Okay. Thank you.
That's a very important.
Especially many people, you know, nowadays we have so many hair oils coming up in as advertisements and what happens is, these are all misguidance. Please do not fall in for it. I would say make sure that you apply just half an hour before your bath because the maximum our body will absorb the material is only for 40 minutes or 45 minutes. After that, it's not going to absorb at all. Then why are we wasting our time and oil for the extra time, yeah, which is actually going to waste.
Question from Vandana ji. Vandana Mehra ji, please go ahead, ma'am. Vandana Mehra. Vandana Mehra ji, please go ahead.
I just wanted to ask, what is the importance of putting the oils in your navel? A lot has been said about that.
In your navel?
Navel, yeah.
Actually, the navel is the primary connection with your mother. I think you are all aware of it. And that is actually considered just like a spoke, you know, like how 24 wheels are being, like in the flag, we have the 24 spokes, no? Just like that. In our navel is also connected with so many of the veins, arteries and all that. So that is why the navel is very important and it's the best absorption area. So especially when you have problems with your pitta and vata, just apply oil there, it will immediately absorb and the reaction will also be the same. You know, it's a very common practice that for pain in abdomen, for babies, to even people with dysmenorrhea and all, just apply castor oil, it will be very effective.
So different oils have different effects.
Of course, sure. All oils have different, the quality of the oil differs and that quality actually gives you the therapeutic effect also.
Okay, thank you so much.
I think we should have another Ayurvedic series again. Somebody raise your hand, please go ahead.
Can I ask the question, please? So this oil of the navel, are you suggesting sesame oil for that?
You can apply, for a regular purpose, you can just apply one drop of sesame oil, that is enough. If at all you have any pain or something, no, you can use castor oil, mustard oil, based on the condition. Yeah.
Okay. And for hair loss, then what do you suggest for hair loss?
Hair loss, I would suggest first apply oil. People don't apply oil first. So that is actually the basic nutrition that we should give. And it can be just coconut oil itself because it is one of the materials that is advised for keshia. It is very good in improving the hair. And first you apply the oil, make sure that the people have some time with the oil also. It is not that immediately apply. And I know people like, especially this college going students, no, they come with so much of oil and then immediately it is shampooed off. And the next day also they do the same thing. It is not going to actually create an effect at all. It has to be like you need to apply only just within 5 ml because that's the maximum that the body requires for improving the hair also. When you're applying this 5 ml itself, we know that it is only 1.1 to 0.10 ml that is going to be absorbed. So that is
not enough. It's not enough for the length of the hair also, no?
You don't have to apply it on the all over the length of the hair. It is only for one weekly once or so you can just apply because it's only that we think it is actually the scalp that has to be oiled. The other part of the when you're trying to put all over the hair, it is only for the purpose that because the children are getting exposed to so much of dust and atmosphere, we have the split ends and all that. In such conditions, there are specific oils also, which has been mentioned for split ends. So though in such, that oils only has to be applied there. Apart from that, it is not going to help much.
So what you are suggesting is coconut oil on the hair on a daily basis?
Yes, 100%. Okay, so
Aramya, before it is getting late, I'm going to quickly wind up with a few, you know, questions that I have as a commoner. Since that we talked about, you know, dinpuriya, which is a daily routine, I understand that it's a wonderful way of healthy living. But then provided with the kind of a work that we are dealing with the name that we are dealing with, you know, that babool neem that we talked about, or daily oil bath that we talked about, or be it, you know, it in your, you know, the daily routine, that a lot of other things that we talked about.
Let me tell you, I never asked you to stop off. Yeah, when you're, you're brushing your teeth. So you need the time for your brushing of teeth. Just take your time to move away from Colgate or Pepsodent and shift to materials which are actually holistic.
Exactly. This is what I wanted to convey. In case if you're already brushing and you're taking 10 minutes of time, instead of that Colgate or whatever that you're using, you will or neem. This is what I just wanted to convey.
Oil,
I mean, you're not putting extra effort into this.
Many of the people ask me about oiling. I would simply say, get one material, one dress of yours for that oil alone. Just half an hour a day, and I would say you don't have to meet me in your lifetime.
Oh my God. Okay. But anyway, we would love to meet you and talk to you about this.
No, actually, I would always suggest things like this, so that it is always good that you keep yourself healthy.
Yes, yes. And coming to oil application, half an hour of oil application, that is what you're doing. What if we can, you know, use that oil 10 minutes every day? Will that suffice, you know, the kind of the help that it does for the body and mind?
I say that 15 to 20 minutes would be the apt, because the oil application, the time you take, at least the 10 minutes of solid time you should have. That is why I say this 20 minutes. Okay, Aparnaji, can we find out?
Follow these things, you know, slowly say that, you know, we don't require Aramya, right?
Exactly. This dinacharya itself was a routine that is to be followed just for maintaining your health. Your vata, pitta and kapha will be intact. And this has to be done especially in the morning hours, so that you are trying to get rid of your vata, which is actually you're trying to awaken your vata, keeping your pitta in balance, trying to improve your appetite for the day, and then putting off your unwanted kapha. All these happens in all these procedures. Okay, so thank you so much for your very patient hearing.
Thank you so much, Amya. Thank you so much.